welcome to the podcast. On this episode, I'm visiting Kentwood Brewing Company, which is out in Preston Pans, which is just outside of Edinburgh. The brewery is inside a building called The Goth, which is the Gothenburg. And I got chatting to Sean Wood, who is one of the two brewers there. I caught him at a really interesting time because him and his business partner, Lewis Kent, have just taken over the runnings of The Goth. So they started out in the brewery and now they've got the whole shebang. So the bar, the kitchen, the wedding venue, the staff, everything. So it's quite a steep learning curve for them. But they are living the homebrewer's dream, I suppose. They started out homebrewing, then they have a small brewery, and then they've got a brewpub. And I mean, not just any brewpub. The Goth is an amazing place. It was built in 1908, and it's a mock Tudor exterior with a beautiful arts and crafts decor, which has been meticulously restored a few years ago. And it's got a seaside location, is beautiful in itself. It's also a social enterprise, so that means that some of the profit that is turned gets put back into the community, and the community uses it as a local hub. So it's no wonder that a place like that demands its brewers to brew a beer that just fits. And the history of the location of the Goth inform the ales that Sean and Lewis brew for their bar, not the other way around. I love that. Anyway, I'll let Sean explain. Here's Sean.
This building is just, from the outside as well, it's just so striking.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
It doesn't really fit in with anything else that's here.
Yeah.
Has this been the hub of Preston Pans for a while then, the Goth, is it?
It was. So in 1908 it was built under the Gothenburg Principles, which basically means that a percentage of... They didn't make money on the beer. Profits from the beer went back into the community. However, they could make money on other things, food, for example. So Gothenburg principles are just that it plays a role in the community rather than just be a pub.
Right.
And so we adhere to many of those principles. We provide office space to many of the community organisations, likes of the Scottish Battlefield Trust, mm-hmm. and many other sort of
local
groups and stuff, you know, and they use this place for events and that sort of thing, really. But this place has been very supportive of many community initiatives and that sort of thing.
Was there like some kind of benefactor who founded it? Or, I mean, how did something as beautiful as this come, you know, in a small mining mm-hmm. town? Was there like a...
There was, and still is. He still owns a building.
Right.
He's Dr. Gordon Preston Grange, and he still owns a building. He's a wonderful old chap. I think he's about 82 years old.
He must be getting on.
And has the energy of a 15-year-old. Uh-huh. And he has been responsible for a lot of things in this town. A, restoring this place. Yeah. B, directly responsible for the creation of a lot of the murals you see on the walls.
All right.
A lot of things that kind of just make the place a bit more attractive. And many, many community initiatives, fundraising for the Wagonway Walk or the Scottish Battlefield Trust and so on, liaising with the Tourist Board and that sort of thing. So, yes, he was the benefactor, shall we say, and I rent this building from him.
Okay. Was he running it before you started renting it?
Or no, there were some partners running.
Right.
Uh-huh. As a management company.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So, you run it now.
Yes.
Tell me a bit more about that.
Okay.
That's just a bit mad.
So myself and my fellow brewer, Mr. Lewis Kent, uh-huh. we started Kentwood Brewing Limited on the 2nd of November 2015.
Not long ago.
Just 1 year ago yesterday.
Uh-huh.
And shortly after that, we came across this place through a series of peculiar conversations, and I think it started in a hairdresser somewhere and it just escalated to the point where I came here to meet the owner.
Right.
And to cut a long story short, we've been brewing their beer here since April of this year when we got a brewing license.
Right, right.
And as of 2 days ago, we took over the lease of the building. So
that's incredible.
That's pretty much the story so far.
You must like it. I mean, you must see potential, and you must have the Gothenburg principles at heart.
Definitely, yeah, yeah. So I'm happy to retain the general principle of the place. I'm a community-minded person. That fits very much with my ethos, you know. Mm-hmm. I was a community councillor in Edinburgh until recently, and various other things I get involved with, to give something back, which I think maybe we all can do in some way in our lives. However, I'm also an entrepreneur, and there's no secret about that. And I'm in business to make it work so I can pay everyone's wages.
Yes,
we now have 13 staff here, so
excellent.
Got to make sure that they're all paid and the bills are paid. And in order to do that, I've got a plan in my head that I'll roll out that utilises this building far more than it currently is.
All right, so
It will be. With the rollout of a calendar of events for the upstairs space, and various other small and sort of medium-sized changes that we'll make downstairs, new menu, hopefully a new way of eating in the bar. Mm-hmm. I want to see people sharing food.
All right.
I want to see people eating together socially, you know.
All right.
So if they're in for a drink, a group of people, there's absolutely no way that they should be resigned to bags of peanuts and crisps, you know.
Yes.
So I want to present something to them that they can share, and it's a social kind of eating environment whilst they're having whatever, a real ale or a bottle of Prosecco between them, whatever, you know.
Yes, that sounds great.
Yeah.
So the brewery that you've got, was there a brewery in here before you started brewing here?
Yes, there was. There have been several in the past,
right,
to be fair, in the, whatever, it's been 10 years or so since it's been around. The last brewers didn't quite fit with the needs of the community and the real ale drinkers that used to use this place and maybe had stopped using it because they weren't getting the variety or the standard of beer that they were looking for.
Right. Okay.
You know.
Yeah. Yeah.
We are listed in the Camera Heritage Pubs of Britain and that sort of thing. And,
yes.
And you know, you have to live up to these sort of titles. You have to, if the campaign for real ale is sort of highlighting what's great about your place, the very least you can do is make the best beer
yes.
you can possibly, right?
Yes.
You know,
or they'll just stop listing you,
yes.
won't they? Yes.
And so that's why we were probably quite well positioned to take over the brewery, because
right.
we're very confident about the beer we're making, and that has now been reflected in the return of many customers that have
excellent.
Said, you know, we're now happy with the beer that's been produced and made here, and it is extremely local. I drive personally 8.1 miles to get the grain from the farm.
Wow.
To bring it here, produce it here, and then whatever it travels 40 feet to get to the tap.
That's
know?
Incredible.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's the dream, isn't
yeah.
it, really?
Uh-huh. So I think that all of these things mean that we're best suited to be the people brewing the beer here.
Yes.
And be the caretakers of this building
yes.
and everything it's about.
That sounds fabulous. The brewery, you took me on a little tour around and I saw the kit. Was that in here? Did you inherit that from the previous brewers? Or
it was the owner of the building that had that installed, I think maybe 10 or so years ago.
Right.
So that's been part of the building for a while.
Were you used to brewing on a kit like that before you came here, or is that a new thing to you?
Well, prior to coming here, the largest thing I had ever brewed in was a 23-litre catering urn. Prior to that was a plastic bucket, also of the same volume.
You're clearly an adventurer.
Yeah, so yes, that was new.
How are you getting on with it? How are you enjoying upscaling like that?
Absolutely perfect.
Good.
Both myself and Lewis can rattle off a batch of beer in absolutely no time at all. It's perfectly fine.
Brilliant. Has Lewis got any experience of brewing prior to this?
about 2 months less than I have.
All right, okay. Crash course.
No.
Did you try out a variety of different beers before you settled on the ones that you've got on kind of standby now? Or how did you come to have the recipes that you use?
The first beers we made here were ones that we made at home.
Right.
And we knew were true to their style. 80 shilling, for example.
Right.
So the 80 shilling that went on here was the 80 shilling that I had made at home. And I was happy with, and
good.
I knew that it would be well received by the, you know, the discerning ale drinkers. And the same goes with IPAs that we put on. The ones that we developed here were, for example, the Wee Heavy.
Yes.
People in Preston Pans, or coming to Preston Pans, expect to be able to get a Wee Heavy, particularly in this place, because the Wee Heavy was originally made by Fowler's Ales in Preston Pans. And
okay.
So it was only natural for us to make sure we had that available.
Yes.
And I believe, and we've had people in here whose grandfather worked at Fowler's Ales, or who remembered themselves having a Wee Heavy and prior to the closure of Fowler's in 1960-ish, and
right.
have said that it's very true to the original. So,
oh, brilliant. Yeah. Uh-huh. That's great. I didn't realise Fowler's were in Preston Pans.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
They're part of the history. So you're continuing that part of the history as well with that ale. What are the other ones that you've got here, and why?
Right, so we have a preference, or not so much a preference, but we discovered we're quite good at doing the dark ales.
All right.
And so we created a 90 shilling, which allowed us to have a series of ales, which starts from 80 shilling, 90 shilling, Wee Heavy, and what we call our Kentwood Number One.
Right.
That's a series of Scottish styles, and that's what we would like to be known for in this place. And from a marketing perspective, it fits very nicely into the branding plans. Beyond that, we're developing some modern styles that roll out to our other pubs.
All right,
as
okay.
well as being served here. So we've created a double chocolate stout, for example, very well received, and we'll keep that on our list of sort of seasonals, I guess.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll go elsewhere. We've developed a couple of IPAs. One is our El Tropicano, which was also very well received here, and that regularly goes on in other Edinburgh pubs, for example.
Okay.
And I've got a chili beer on right now.
All right.
That was created for Halloween.
Uh-huh.
We had a Mexican Day of the Dead, actually, and so we put chili beer on for that.
Right.
And yeah, we will continue to develop some more contemporary styles.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. And perfect our core Scottish range.
Right. So do you produce beers for other people outside of your own clientele here? So if you go to different pubs and provide them with their...
Correct, yes, we do, as well as festivals.
Uh-huh.
External festivals are going to be a big part in our business. We had, I think, two beers on at the Bowness Real Ale Festival recently. We had five beers on in the Nottingham Beer Festival.
Right.
We've got one, our 80 shilling is on right now down in North Berwick in the Nether Abbey Hotel Beer Festival.
Right.
So festivals will play a big part, as well as pubs. Pubs less so, however, you know, there'll always be at least a pub that you'll get our beer on.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. That's great. I mean, it's impressive because the brewery looks small, but you said you had the three or four fermentation vessels that allow you to brew this amount of beer, because that's a lot of beer you're talking about here, different styles and different mm-hmm. outlets and so on. It's really impressive, especially if you haven't been coming from a big brewing background, you're just developing it all yourself. Hats off.
you just need to do what you got to do. And I think it doesn't seem that difficult to me, because
all right.
you love doing it.
Right.
And that's maybe that's maybe why we're able to juggle all these things about with effortlessly. There have been challenges, you know. We've had pumps explode or whatever, you know. We've had ups and downs, but generally, producing beer and racking it, whether it's into casks or bottles, is second nature now.
Yes,
and, you know,
you love it.
Yeah.
I suppose that helps.
Yeah.
And speaking of bottles, do you do a lot of bottles, or is it, if you're providing the festivals and other pubs, is it mostly casks?
Casks to pubs. We've done some small batch bottling, sort of hand bottling. We've got a 6-head bottling device,
right,
that we can bottle directly from conditioning tank. The small batch bottling, mostly for here, and for, we've done a couple of private events that have wanted bottles as well as casks.
Right.
So that sort of thing. However, we do plan to roll out or increase our bottling. We will do that by actually bringing a mobile bottling plant outside.
I've heard of these, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And once again, to try and sort of keep those sort of green principles, as it were. You know, I think it is far more environmentally friendly if we can have the product as local and as less travelled as possible.
Right.
And so, you know, on top of the 8.1 miles it takes for the grain to get to here from the farm, another 100 feet or so into a vehicle outside,
uh-huh,
should allow us to retain those principles.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. No, that's great.
Yeah.
You say the beers have been well received.
Mm-hmm.
Have there been any awards that you've picked up, or have you recently been?
Well, whilst we were recently finalists in the inaugural Scottish Beer Awards.
You know, that I think that's why I'm asking. I think I heard,
yes,
something about that. That's incredible.
Yes, so we made it to the finals, and it was a pretty large, very competitive group. We were in best British ale style.
That's
so it was our wee heavy, actually.
Right, right.
That made it to the finals. We didn't win, but we were in very, very substantial company.
Oh.
And to be fair, as beer enthusiasts, or, you know, enthusiastic real ale drinkers, we were very pleased for the winners of our category, because they were beers that we ourselves love. So
yes,
and the brewing industry is like that, right?
Yes, uh-huh.
You know, so.
No hard feelings.
No. Hey, we're less than 1 year old, right?
Yes, you know? That's it. I mean, it's incredible.
You know,
absolutely incredible.
There will be more.
Yes, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Yes. If people want to take beer home, what way could they do that? Do you have like a growler system, or do you have bottles for sale at the bar? Or if I wanted to take one wee heavy with me home tonight.
Right. Well, as of last month, we got our off license.
Right.
So we are now permitted to sell beer to take away.
Excellent.
Yes. We have some bottles produced just now, and the labels are still being designed.
Right.
Because they have to be in a different format for the mobile bottling plant. So I'm getting our current bottles in the same format.
Right, right.
You know.
Uh-huh.
And small issues like barcoding is kind of holding things up.
Of course, yes.
Yeah. Uh-huh. But yes, you can buy beer here to take away. We will have the bottles on the bar very shortly. And we will also, because we're very kind like that, we will also host beers from other East Lothian breweries.
All right.
We'd like to think that we will play a bit of a role in getting East Lothian recognised as the brewing capital of Scotland, which, generally speaking, it kind of is. Your barley's come from here. Historically, we've made fantastic beers in this region. And a lot of things about East Lothian that should be recognised within the brewing industry. And we'll do our part, for sure. And we will, as I say, also stock beers from other local brewers.
I think it's probably not that widely known that the best grain comes from here for being
correct
brewing, really. I mean,
correct. So that needs to be rectified right away.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I could be the person to do that, hopefully.
Yes.
Yeah. Well,
no, absolutely. Yeah, that's a good starting point for putting yourself on the map and your area.
Yeah.
Absolutely. While I was in in your bar, which is gorgeous, by the way, all the original wood and so on, I noticed on your blackboard that you invite people to come and brew here for a day.
That's right.
What's that about?
Oh, that's a fun thing to do. So we offer brew days as an experience, and it typically starts in the morning, early-ish, with sort of preparing the grain bill and choosing a recipe and amongst us. It's a group activity, you know,
right.
Best done with three or four people. And we'll choose a recipe amongst ourselves and prepare the grain bill. We will take everyone through the brewing process, making sure that everybody taking part actually is able to do something. Mm-hmm. So they're not just watching us brew. Far from it, we'll stand back as much as we can, and so that they can make the beer under our sort of supervision. There are gaps in that process. For example, when you're mashing in, you've typically got an hour that you can either do something within the brewery, or you can spend it drinking beer. We will choose to spend it drinking beer.
Right.
And we'll call it beer tasting. So we'll have a little beer tasting session in there. Mm-hmm. We'll take it through to the next stage of sparging, and then when it's into the kettle, and as long as there's no sign of it boiling over and the kettle seems safe to leave unattended, we may drink some more beer.
Oh, yes.
So more beer tasting. And at the end of it, once the beer's into the fermentation vessel, in between there will be some food. They'll have some breakfast and some lunch.
All right.
Uh-huh. Once it's in the fermentation vessel, it's then, of course, has to stay there for a week or so to ferment. Now, what we don't offer is for them to stay for that whole week.
Of course.
You know, that would be inconvenient for everyone concerned. So they will come back.
Yes.
A week or so later. Uh-huh. And they're welcome to help with racking the beer, whether into casks, and we will rack some into bottles.
All right. Mm-hmm.
And all participants will get to take some bottles away with them. So we will have labels designed, and their beer will go on the bar.
Uh-huh.
With a specially designed pump clip that they will have had some part in designing.
Nice.
Mm-hmm. And yeah, that's pretty much a full day, 5-6 hours, something like this.
How much beer are you making in that session?
We will do, depends on what it is. So it will either be a 350-litre or a 500-litre batch.
So you're right, okay.
Yeah, so substantial amount.
That's substantial, yes. Mm, uh-huh. And yeah. And then the people of Preston Pans can enjoy it for a week or so until it's
yes,
a good one.
Yes, and they will have their commemorative bottles to take away and share with friends.
Uh-huh. That sounds great.
Yeah.
If I was feeling greedy and wanted to make 500 litres for myself for a wedding or something, I'm just speculating now, mm-hmm. would you allow other brewers to come here and make some beer? Is that something that you do as well?
They could do. We'd need to look at each case individually.
Uh-huh.
But yes, they could do. We are currently, for example, we've got Scottish craft brewers coming along.
Yes.
Making a beer here. And that's a case where we completely step back, because
right.
they know what they're doing.
Uh-huh.
And they will sort of just use our kit.
Yes. Uh-huh.
So they're making a beer here, which will be going into whiskey barrels, I believe, or barrels of some sort, and then aged and matured and conditioned, I guess, in the barrels.
Yes. So I'd heard something about that. Is that do they bring the barrels along with
yeah.
that?
Or,
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, they've got that already.
So it's something we're already doing. It's just we need to look on a case by case basis. Uh-huh. Depends on what you want to do, and you know.
I'm surprised you've got the capacity to even entertain the thought with so much beer going out.
Yeah, we juggle things about. It's actually not a problem. Yeah.
Would you consider expanding the brewery? I mean, if it took off, is there room?
Most definitely, yes. Now, if you've had a look at the microbrewery, and
yeah.
you see that the fermentation vessels, for example, are 105 centimetres high.
Yes.
Plus the legs. We could easily accommodate double height fermentation vessels. So to expand, we could actually just replace those with ones double the height. And the same goes with some of the other kit. We can just grow up the weight. We also have an alleyway at the side of the microbrewery where there is space to put whatever conditioning vessels or whatever.
Put them there,
So there is room for a small expansion, 100% expansion.
With just some welding work required, yes. That's excellent. So I've heard about your plans for the future. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Something that you think we've not covered?
Apart from hosting our first wedding tomorrow.
Yes, good luck with that.
Yeah, thank you. We will be running a beer festival or two throughout next year.
Excellent.
And there'll be a bit of a calendar of events gets rolled out. That will all become made public once it's finalised. But
on your website and Facebook?
Facebook's the best place. That way we can communicate directly with people and whatever, you know. Facebook. Kentwood Brewing, find us on Facebook. That's the best place to find out, or Twitter, what we're up to. These pages should be fairly active as time goes on. Just now we're going through a transition of folding the whole thing into a small company, you know.
Of course, yes.
We've went from a stage of just being two brewers to now having 13 employees and a large property to look after and a car park.
That's a bit of a shock to the system.
That sort of thing, it takes a little bit of a transition going on. But yes, the plans will be rolled out very shortly.
Excellent. Well, thanks for talking to me. That's great.
You're welcome.
And good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Really exciting time.
Yeah, I know.
I really enjoyed talking to Sean and finding out all his interesting news. So I hope you did too. And I hope that next time you're anywhere near Preston Pans, you'll stop by the Goth and try their beer and their food. And wish them all the best. The show notes will have links to the Kentwood Brewing website and to the Goth. So if you want any more information, that's where to go. Till next time.